Good morning, one and all. So in the last class we have seen some examples for conditional probability, and this is the final way of writing unconditional probability using conditional probability. So we have solved some problems. Let us go to the multiplication rule. It is very simple rule which we have derived from the concept of conditional probability. What it says is, this is what we have written from conditional probability, but it is only for two events. What are they? A1 and A2. Now suppose let us take three events. How it would be? So probability of A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 will be equal to probability of A1 into probability of A2 given A1. Next would be probability of A3 given A1 intersection A2. This is called multiplication rule. Okay. Now in general, what would happen if there are n number of events? What would happen? So probability of A1 intersection A2 intersection so on AN will be equal to probability of A1 into probability of A2 given A1. Next, probability of A3 given A1 intersection A2. So on. What would be the last one? Probability of AN given A1 intersection A2 intersection so on. AN minus 1. So this is what we write. It is something like multiplication. Okay. Suppose what would you write if there are four events? What would happen if there are four events? Suppose if I want to ask probability of A1 intersection, A2 intersection, A3 intersection, A4. What would you write? What would you write? Probability of A1 into probability of A2 given A1. So after writing A2, you should write the previous one. Next. So probability of A3 given, for A3, what are the previous events? A1 intersection A2. Next, probability of A4 given. So for A4, what are the previous events? A1 intersection A2 intersection A3. This is what we write as a multiplication rule. Okay. Now same thing is being written in the form of intersection unions. Okay. It is very simple rule, so nothing to worry about this. So first write down the event. Next, event given the previous events. So on. You write up to last event. Okay. Now, so based on that multiplication rule, let us take one problem. What problem says is, three chords are drawn from an ordinary 52 card deck without replacement. Okay, so we draw a card from the pack of 52 cards without replacement. We don't replace it. We don't put it back. We wish to find out the probability that none of the three cards is a heart. So we are drawing three cards one by one without replacing. Now we have to find out what's the probability that all three cards that are drawn are not heart. So we assume that at each step, each one of the remaining cards is equally likely to be picked. Okay. So first of all, let us go to the card. So in a card, there are two colors, red color and black color. In red color, we have two suits. They're called suits. What are they? Heart, diamond. In black also, we have two suits. They are club and spade. What is the number? Each and every suit has 13 numbered cards. Okay, so let me go back. So if take a card of deck of 52 cards, total cards are 52. You know these things. Okay, so among 52, so red color are 26. Next, remaining 26 are black color. In black, we have two suits. What are they? Go here. Club and spade. Club and spade. How many number are there? 13 clubs and 13 spades. In the same way, in red color also we have two suits. What are they? Heart and diamond. Hearts are 13, diamonds also 13. So total 52. So you know already what are those heart, 13 hearts, all those things. What will happen? First we have a card, ace card. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next, jack, queen, king. Anyway, so this is what the order. Anyway, so we don't need all this information, only we need this information, that is enough for this problem. So what problem says? The problem says we are drawing three cards without replacement and wish to find out probability that none of these three cards is a heart. Okay. Now what should be the event here? Event, let us take AI is the event, which implies what is the event? So the ith card that you draw is not heart. Where I was from, where? 1, 2, 3. So the first card is not heart, second card is also not heart, the third also not heart. This is what the event is. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out probability of what? What is A1? A1 is the first card is not hot. It should be followed. Next, intersection. What is A2? The second card is not hot. Intersection. What is A3? The third card is also not hot. Now what does it mean? So probability that the first card and second card and third card that you draw is not hot. That is what you want, because you have to find out the probability that none of the cards that you draw is a hot. Means all three cards should not be a hot. That is simple meaning. Okay. Now, so let us apply our multiplication rule. What it says? Just have written. So the probability of A1 into probability of A2 given A1 into probability of A3 given A1 intersection A2. Okay. Now, so we have to find out these three probabilities. This is a normal probability and remaining are conditional probabilities. This is a conditional probability, it is another conditional probability. So let us go with the first one, P of A1. What is A1? What is event A1? A1 means the first card that you draw is not a hot. What is the probability? We have 52 cards. Among 52, we are picking one card. So what is the probability that is not hot? Can you tell me? Only 13 are hearts. What about remaining? 13, 13, 13, 39 are not hearts. So please make a note of this. 13 are hearts, remaining 39 are not hearts. Okay, now we will find out the probability of picking a not heart 39 by total cards are 52. Okay, that is simple probability. I think you appreciate this point. So the probability that you pick a card that is not heart, 39 by total cards are 52. Please remember, now after first attempt we have picked one card which is not heart. Okay, now total number of cards becomes 51 only. You have taken one card out of that. Okay, so we are not replacing, that's why the total number of cards are 51. Okay, so 51, among 51, 13 are hearts, remaining 38 are not hearts. See, please make a note of this. In the first draw you might have taken one diamond or one club or one spade, but not heart. Okay, we don't bother what you have taken. The only thing is that is not heart. That is what important to us. Okay, so that is P of A1, correct? Next, so what do we want next? P of A2 given A1. This is a conditional probability. What it says? So the probability that the second card is not hot, given that the first is also not hot. Okay, can you tell me this? Can you get this probability? So the second card is not hot, given that the first one is also not hot. Okay, now so after the first draw you're left with only 51 cards. Among 51, 13 are odds and so these are not 39. This should be what 38 only. Now this is a scenario. We have a 13 odds, 38 not odds, and we have to find the probability that you take a card which is not hot among only 51 cards. Please make a note of this. Now what is that probability? What is this probability would be? 38 by 51. Next, so last probability. Probability that A3 given A1 intersection A2. What it says? So the probability of picking a card which is not hard in the third attempt, given that the first two are also not hards. Okay, so quickly write down this. What is that? Now after second attempt, what is the scenario? You have only 50 cards. Among 50, 13 are hards, 30. Now this would be 37 are not hards. 37 are not hards. That would be 37 are not odds. That is after second draw. Now what would happen now? That is, so among 37 given by 50. Now you calculate all these three, you would get the answer. So please remember this. So what is the probability that A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 would be equal to, so 39 by 52, 38 by 51 into 37 by 50. So here you can solve directly. I mean, without using multiplication rule also you can solve it. It is not a big deal, but I would explain how to solve this by using multiplication rule. Is it clear? Now in the same problem I asked few more subparts. The first one is not hot and the second one is hot. What is the probability? The first one is not hot but second one is hot. Can you guess the probability? So A, please read the problem properly. The first one is not hot and the second one is hot. What is that? First one is hot means how many hearts are there? 13 out of 52. Next, second one is not hot means 39 by 51. Okay, next B. What B says? The first two are not odds, means 39 by 52 into 38 by 51. They are not odds. And third one is odd, means 13 by 50. Okay. You read the problem properly, you will get to know the answer. That is not a big deal. Okay. So next, we move on to the total probability theorem. This is one more concept which is very, very important. Okay. First, read the definition of the total probability theorem. What it says? Let A1, A2, AN are disjoint events that form a partition of a sample space. You know what is disjoint events and what is a partition of the sample space. Yeah. We assume that the probability of each and every event is positive. It should be positive. Then for any event B, we have these things. Okay. So let me explain with simple concept. Okay. Now, let me take a sample space okay. So this is the sample space, let us assume. Let us take it is partitioned into some parts. Okay. It is partitioned into some parts. Let us take for example something like that. Okay. Now, so I am taking only for example purpose. This is A1, this is A2, this is A3. So what is this? This is a sample space omega. Now omega is being partitioned into three events. What are they? A1, A2, A3. A1, A2, A3 are partitions of what? Omega. How are they? A1, A2, A3 should be disjoint, or they are also called as mutual exclusive. And furthermore, what is omega should be? A1 union A2 union A3. Okay. What is A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 should be? Null set or empty set. That is the whole definition of partition. Okay. Now, so this is what the case. Now here we have any event, some event B. We are defining one more event B. Okay. We are defining an event B. Okay. Now what it says? What is the event B will be? Can you guess? How can you write B? B is A1 intersection B. What is A1 intersection B? Which part? This part. A1 intersection B. Union. Next. What is next? A2 intersection B. This is what? A2 intersection B. Union. What is this? That is A3 intersection B. Do you agree or not? I am writing B, the event B, as A1 intersection B, this part, union, A2 intersection B, this part, union, A3 intersection B, this part, and furthermore, all these three events are what? Disjoint. Okay. Now, so to write it simpler, in a simple way, we have this event B, which is having some portion, something like that, which is something like this. This portion is what? A1 intersection B. This portion is A2 intersection B, and this portion is A3 intersection B, and the total B is union of all such three events. Do you agree or not? B is this portion, union this portion, union this portion, but these three portions are disjoint because they don't have anything in common. Now here, what can I write? P of B equal to, this is, I'm using properties. If A and B are disjoint, probability of A union B equal to the probability of A plus probability of B. In the same way, so if these three are disjoint, I can write the probability of B equal to probability of A1 intersection B plus probability of A2 intersection B plus probability of A3 intersection B. And furthermore, you know from the concept of conditional probability, what is P of A1 intersection B? What is that? P of B given A1 into P of A1. What is probability of A2 intersection B? P of B given A2 into P of A2. Isn't it? In the same way, what is probability of A3 intersection B? That would be equal to probability that B of A3 into probability of A3. But what is P of B? Sum of all these probabilities. Now finally, P of B equal to, what you can write? P of B given A1 into P of A1 plus P of B given A2 into P of A2 plus P of B given A3 into P of A3. So I have written for only three cases. It could be for any number of cases. Generally, we take it for n number of such cases. Okay. Now that is what is being written here. So P of B equal to P of A1 into P of B given A1 plus so on. Finally, P of AN into P of B given AN. That is called total probability theory. So here, simply assume like that. We have a sample space that is partitioned into several parts, several events. The events should be disjoint and they should be collectively exhaustive, obviously. And we have any other event B. So now that B can be found out by using this total probability theorem, which says that probability of B equal to probability of A1 into probability of B given A1 plus so on, probability of AN into probability of B given AN. Yeah. So to support that statements, let us take a simple problem. The problem is something like this. You enter a chess tournament where your probability of winning a game is how much? Winning a game is 0.3 against half of the players. Call them type 1, 0.4 for one quarter and 0.5 for another quarter. You play a game against a random chosen opponent. What is the probability of winning? That is what is being asked. Okay. Now, so read the problem properly. So let us proceed for the next one. Now, what they mentioned is, so I will take like this. Okay, what they are saying is, suppose there is a chess tournament. There is a chess tournament. So you take something like this. Okay, so you take your class. You take your class. Class of 60 students. Okay. Class of 60 students. So a person is playing against your class, but before that your class is divided into three parts. Okay, type 1, it contains, so your class strength is, let us take 60 for example, total number of students in a class are 60, they are divided into three parts. What are they? Type 1, they contain 30, half of the students are type 1. Type 2, it contains 15 students. Type 3 contains again remaining 15 students. So the total class is being partitioned into three categories or three types. Type 1, type 2, type 3. In type 1 there are 30 students, type 2 15, type 3 also 15. Okay. Now, so a person comes from the outside, so they will play with you. Okay. Now, so randomly one student will be selected. That student may belong to type 1, type 2 or type 3, we don't know. Randomly one student is selected. Okay. And that guy who came from outside will play with that particular student. And we are asking, so what the probability that he will win? The probability that the person will win, the person who has come from outside, let us take. Now, so here this is what the condition or scenario. In this scenario, so let us define a special event B. What is event B? What is event B? Guess it. It is event of winning. B means event of winning. That is what you have to find out. You have to find out that what is the probability that you will win. Before that, what is given? So, probability of selecting a student from type 1. What is that? What is the probability that you select a student from type 1? Type 1 means 30 by total 60. 30 by 60. So this is a probability that you select a student from type 1. In the same way, what is the probability that you select a student from type 2? What is that? 15 by 60, 1/4. In the same way, what is the probability that you select a student from type 3? 15 by 60, again 1/4. This is the probability of selecting a student from type 1 or type 2 or type 3. Now, what is given in the question? What is given? Let me go to the question. You enter a chess tournament where the probability of winning a game is 0.3 against half of the player or type 1. If you play with the type 1 students, the probability that you will win is how much? 0.3. Next. 0.4 against quarter of the player called type 2, and 0.5 against the remaining quarter of the player type 3. Now this is what they given is, they given the conditional probabilities. Okay, so what is B? It is the event which says the probability of winning. Now here probability of you will win, provided if you play against type 1. If you play against type 1, how much? 0.3. In the same way, probability of winning, given that you play against type 2 students, what is that? How much is given? 0.4. Next, probability that you play with probability of winning, given that you play with type 3 students, that is how much is given? 0.5. Now you have these probabilities, you have these probabilities, but what do you want? What do you want? Probability that that person will win. Now what is that? Probability of T1 into probability of B given T1 plus probability of T2 into probability of B given T2 plus probability of T3 into probability of B given T3. What it would be? Any guesses? Can you calculate this? That would be equal to 1 by 2 into 0.3. If I'm not wrong, please. 1 by 4 into 0.4 plus 1 by 4 into 0.5. Is it correct? You check it once. Maybe it is 0.375. You calculate this. I hope it is correct. You go with these simple calculations, you may get the answer. Okay. Next, that is about total probability theorem. Next problem. Okay. So the next problem is something like this. We roll a fair four-sided die. Four-sided die means it is D4 die. D4 means it has got four sides. Output could be either 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. If the result is 1 or 2, then we will roll once more. Otherwise, we stop. Which means, so you roll a die. If you are getting 1 or 2, you will roll one more time. If you are getting 3 or 4, you stop there. You don't roll one more time. What is the probability that the sum total of our rolls is at least 4? Yeah, this is what the question. Now, here also you can solve this by, first of all, you write whatever you know. Otherwise, whatever is given in the problem, you write. Okay, without any confusion, you write what is given in the problem. The problem says, you are rolling a die. Outcome could be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, so what is the probability of getting 1? So this is all are equiprobable. So the probability of getting 1 and the probability of getting 2 and the probability of getting 3. If you roll a die, you may get 1, 2, 3 or 4. So the probabilities of getting each and every output could be same, that is 1 by 4. Isn't it? Now what is we have to find out is event B, that is sum of rolls is at least 4. At least 4 means greater than or equal to 4. The sum of the rolls, suppose you may roll one time or two time, doesn't matter. The sum should be at least 4, or at least 4 means 4 or more than 4. Okay. Now, so what could happen? Suppose you may take something like this. AI is the event. What do you say event? The result is I. Result of your role is I. Result of your role is I. Now what is A1? A1 says that the result of a roll, first roll, roll is 1. What is that? 1 by 4. Because, so if you roll a die, you may get 1. What is the getting 1? Probability 1 by 4. Something like that. So result of getting 2 also 1 by 4. Getting 3 and 4 also 1 by 4. I am just defining an event. okay, two events are there, B and AI. Okay. Now, so here comes the, now if I ask you what is the probability of B given A1, you understand this properly. What I am asking, probability that the sum is at least 4 given that A1 means what? You get 1 in the first time, but please remember, if you get 1 in the first time, you roll one more time, correct? Isn't it? So now what is the probability? Okay, before that, so this is what we have to find out. What happens? You're rolling a die, you got 1. Then what happens? You roll one more time. So how many such probabilities are there? Okay, so if you roll a die for the first time, if you get 1, you roll one more time. Then what may happen? You may get 1-1 possibility, isn't it? So first time 1 you're getting, second time you get 2, sorry. First roll you got 1, you roll one more time, you may get 2. Here you rolled first time, you got 1, which means you roll one more time, there also you may get 1. You may get 1, 2, you roll a die, you got 1, then you roll one more time, you may get 3. You roll a die, you may get 1. So obviously you have to roll one more time, you may get 4. This is a scenario where if you get 1 in the first roll. Now, but what I'm asking here is, what's the probability that sum is at least 4? These are all possibilities if you get 1 for the first time. But among these, the sum of the rolls is at least 4. Now this is sum is 2. The sum is 3, not possible. But these two are having sum 4, sum 5. Now these two are comes into picture. Now what is the probability now? Two are having sum more than 4 or more than equal to 4 out of total number of outcomes are 4. So that is 1 by 2. This probability is how much? 1 by 2. I hope you appreciate this point. Isn't it? Now let us find out probability that the sum is at least 4 given that you get 2 in the first time. Now what happens here? You roll a die, you got 2 in the first time, you roll one more time, you may get 1. Another possibility, you got first as a 2, you may roll one more time, you may get 2. Next, 2, 3, 2, 4. These are all possibilities. Please remember, A2 means you got 2 in the first time. Now among all these 3, 4, whose sum is more than or equal to 4? The sum is 3, it is not correct. It is 4, 5, 6. So these two are having sum at least 4. Obviously, 3 among 4. What the probability will be? 3 by 4. Now, next. Now, suppose A3. A3 means what? You got a roll, otherwise you got result as 3 in the first attempt. Please remember, if it is so, you are not allowed to roll one more time. The first roll is 3, which means second attempt is not allowed. So what is the probability that the sum is more than or equal to 4 given that you got 3 in the first attempt? You may get only 3. 3 is less than 4. So what is the probability? 0. Now A4 means what? First roll is 4. Here also you are not allowed to roll one more time. First roll is 4. So no, another attempt is not allowed. But you got 4, correct? In the first itself, you got 4. What is the probability that? What is the probability that? Sum is 4, given that you got 4 in the first attempt. It is 1. At least 4 means 4 also included, no? You got 4 right away. In the first attempt itself, you got 4. Yeah, in the at least means it should be equal to 4 or more than 4, but you got 4. So you're not allowed one more time. Obviously, there is no another attempt. So this is obviously always 1. Now find out total probability. What it says? Probability of B equal to probability of A1 into probability of B given A1 plus probability of A2 into probability of B given A2 plus probability of A3 into probability of B given A3 plus probability of A4 into probability of B given A4. Here I can remove which term? This term. This term is 0. Because P of B given A3 is 0. Just now we have seen this. You just calculate remaining terms. What the answer will be? 1 by 4 into P of B given A1, how much? 1 by 2. Plus 1 by 4 into B given A2, how much? 3 by 4. This is 0. P of A4 means 1 by 4 into, it is 1. You can take 1 by 4 common. Anyway, P of A1, P of A2 are equiparable, no? The equiparable means they are always equal. You can take that common. 1 by 4. It is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. It is 1 by 4 into 2 plus 1 by 2. You do the calculations. How much? Sorry, I made a mistake, right? Yeah. Sorry. You calculate the answer. Okay, I made a mistake here. You take 1 by 4 common and tell me the answer. Okay. To do it yourself, right? So we proceed further. Next, we proceed for Bayes' rule. It is very, very important. Okay. Now we derive this from the concept of total probability theorem itself. Okay. Now here, what do we write? What I write here is Bayes' theorem. This is very, very important. What it says? Simply, P of A given B equal to P of AI into P of B given A by P of B. This is the basic of Bayes' rule. Before that, so let us go to the conditional probability. What have you written? P of A given B equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. Suppose if I write reverse, P of B given A, what do you write? P of B given A, what do you write? P of B intersection A by P of A. Now from these two, what is the conclusion? What you can write? What you can write? P of A given B equal to, tell me what you write. Otherwise, let me write everything properly. Now, what is from this equation? From equation 1, let us take this equation 2. From equation 1, what is P of A intersection B? What is this? This into this, which means P of A given B into P of B. Correct? From equation 2, what is P of A intersection B? What is this? Obviously, this into this. P of B given A into P of A. So, these two are equal. Obviously, these two should be equal. Isn't it? Which means, what I want to say is, so simply I can say P of A intersection B equal to P of A given B into P of B. It is also equal to what? P of B given A into P of A. This is what I want to write. Very, very important. Okay. Now, by using this, what is P of A given B? What is P of A given B? You just tell me. What is P of A given B? Okay. P of A given B can be also written as P of A intersection B by P of B. But what is P of A intersection B? You can take this last term. P of B given A into P of A. P of B given A into P of A by P of B. This is P of A given B. Correct? Now same thing is being written here. I have written P of A given B, which means P of B given A into P of A by P of B. Here in these examples I have taken A and B only for explanation purpose. If it is AI, let me take AI here. If I take AI, it would be AI. It would be AI. That's it. Correct? Now this is what the Bayes theorem. But in the denominator we have P of B. But we know from the total probability, the what is P of B? What is P of B? P of A1 into P of B given A1 plus so on P of A1 into P of B given A1. Now finally, so this denominator I am replacing with total probability theorem. P of A given B equal to P of B given A into P of A by, in the denominator I am writing P of B by using the concept of total probability theorem, for which says P of B equal to P of A1 into P of B given A1 plus so on plus P of An into P of B given An. So we have derived this Bayes theorem from the concept of conditional probability and total probability theorem. So this is the final definition of Bayes' theorem. But before that, so everything is same. Let A1, A2 are disjoint events that form partition of the sample space, and A1 probability of AI is always positive. Then for any event B, everything is same. Only thing is we have rewritten the formulas. It's not a new formula, it's a rewritten formula. Okay. Now what is that implication of Bayes' theorem? Okay. Let me take a simple example. Suppose in the problem of chess problem, suppose you win, then what is the probability that you had opponent of type 1? Okay. Let me go to the chess problem one more time. Yeah. Here, what you have done? So we had a class of 60 students. We divide them into one fourth, and we have chosen a random student, and I have played with that random students. Then we have found out what the probability of winning. But here, what I'm asking is, what the probability, suppose I won the match. Okay, so let me go back to the problem. Yeah, here, so here we have found out what the probability of winning. We have found out, you got some answer. What answer we got? 0.375, it's okay. So that's the probability of winning. Okay, in that example, that's the probability of winning. But what I'm asking is, suppose you won the match, you won the chess match. But what is the probability that your opponent is from type 1? Is from type 1. Or you may ask, what is the probability that you won the match, but your opponent from type 2 or type 3? Okay. Now in the example, what I'm asking is, suppose you won the match, but what is the probability that you had an opponent of type 1, or you had an opponent of half of the class students? Type 1 means what? Half of the students. Okay. Now how to find out that? Can you tell me? By using Bayes' theorem only. Here, what they're asking? You won the match. What is given? You won the match. Okay. So probability that you won the match, that is given. But what the probability that you had an opponent from type 1? This is what they are asking. What they are asking? You had opponent of type 1. Okay, now what do you write? P of T1 given B. Okay, you go with here. T1 given B. In place of A, I have T1. B given T1 into P of T1 by P of B. So you just write this in the form of conditional probability. Probability of B given T1 into P of T1 by P of B. Correct? Now, so P of B given T1 into P of T1 by, what is P of B from the total probability theorem? P of T1 into P of B given T1 plus P of T2 into P of B given T2 plus P of T3 into P of B given T3. So for your understanding, already we have found out this denominator. No need to write also. You found out, no? This question is already being solved. How much answer you got? Is it correct? Check it once. You also know P of B given T1 is 0.3. What is P of T1? All these things is already calculated. P of T1 is 1 by 2. It is 1 by 4. It is 1 by 4. B given T1 is 0.3. P of T1 is 1 by 2. These two things we want. Finally, B of T1 is 0.3 into 1 by 2 means 0.5. Otherwise, let me write 1 by 2 only. 0.3 into 1 by 2 by 0.375, which means 0.3 into 0.5 by 0.375. This is what is the probability that you won the match, but your opponent is of type 1. Suppose if I ask you, what is P of T2 given B? What I'm asking is, you had already won the match, but what is the probability that the opponent is of type 2? Then what do you write? P of B given T2 into P of B. You calculate, you know P of B given T2, you know P of T2. You just calculate the answer. If I ask you one more question, suppose you won the match, what is the probability that your opponent is of type 3? What would you write? It says that P of B given 3 into P of T3 by P of B. So all these things, you know, everything, you know, just substitution is required. Everything is already being given in the previous example. Just you have to substitute the numericals. That's it. Okay. I hope you can calculate these two also. I leave it to you. Okay. Now, so that is about Bayes theorem. Now you might have wondered, what is the importance of Bayes theorem? Okay. Now in the same example, we are doing the reverse of the Trudell probability theorem. In Trudell probability, you will find out what is the probability that you won the match, or what is the probability that something has happened. But here we do something like that. Something has happened, but what is the probability that it belongs to that particular incident? Okay, you take the chess example. Using total probability theorem, we just find out the probability that you won the match. But here in the Bayes theorem, we are finding, suppose you won the match, but what is the probability that your opponent is of type 1 or of type 2 or of type 3? Okay. So to understand these theorems, you just find out, you just try to remember this simple diagram. Whenever you get any confusion, you try to remember this simple diagram, which says, so everything is divided into partitions. Okay. So some events. This is A1, A2, A3. It can be any number of disjoint events. May not be like this. A1, A2, A3. Now we define any other event. We define any other event B. So by using total probability theorem, we find out what is the probability of B. That is the total probability theorem. Okay. Now using Bayes theorem, what do you find out? You find out probability that A1 given B, or probability that A2 given B, or probability that A3 given B. So this is Bayes theorem. This is total probability theorem. This is overall sample space. Okay. So we stop here. If any problems are there, I will discuss in one more class. Okay.